ended up with some sects like the Pharisees or the Essenians or the Sadducees. But when Jesus came, he had nothing to do with his sects. So, dear brethren, Jesus has prayed that we be kept from the evil of the world, not from the world itself. In today's readings, I mean for the Sunday of Ascension, Jesus says, I pray not that thou shouldst take them out of the world, but that thou shouldst keep them from evil. So, dear brethren, we have a mission. We should not fear to work in the world like the devil. Maybe we can feel our weaknesses, some fears, but we must ask for an increase of faith. We must remember that all power has been given to our Lord, the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. All power has not been given to the media, or to the power of flesh, or to the power of money. It's like today the media are all powerful. No, all power has been given to Christ, the King, the Sovereign King. What he needs is some instruments. Armed with faith and spirit of sacrifice and dedication. The apostles also felt their weaknesses. What did they do? A novena to the Holy Ghost. And once they received the Holy Ghost, they were strong, like soldiers with weapons, fearing nothing, even not death. We are at this period of time, the brethren, we need heroes. And we are in this season, liturgical season, we need to pray to the Holy Ghost. Seriously. We have to take our religion seriously. Without the Holy Ghost, we cannot do nothing. Our life will be useless. Yes, in this case, better to die. But no, we are called to do great things for our blessed Lord who has given his life for us. In return for his love, let us love him until the end. Let us pray to the Holy Ghost. Let us be missionaries for the good causes in this world. The cause for life, the cause for the mass, the cause for the restoration of Christian Catholic education in schools. There is a lot to do. Restoration for families and sanctity of matrimony, marriage. We need more than ever the grace of the Holy Ghost. Jesus has promised he will not let us orphan. He will not let us alone. Sometimes we feel kind of, yes, isolation and discouragement, even loneliness, because we try to fill our hearts with worldly things. But worldly things just give us a foretaste of death. Let us renounce ourselves. Let us renounce the worldly and false joys of this world to embrace the true joys of Jesus Christ and the true joys of heaven. We will not feel lonely anymore. Jesus is our best friend. He dwells within us. And with him, we can change the world. And with him, we will gain heaven. We will bring to heaven what we have done with him. His mission is not ended. Some sometimes say, oh, Jesus has done his mission. No. He's working with us, as we said in the gospel. He's working in this world and working to prepare a place for us in heaven. Let us think for a moment of our place in heaven. There are different places. Some are, you know, in the world people look for best places. They want to be the best. The first place. You go to a banquet, you look for the best place. You don't like to be forgotten, to be ignored, to be put aside. And in every group, people look for best place of honor. In heaven, the same. There are places better than others. But Jesus said, yes, the first will be the last. The last will be the first. So, dear brethren, let us work wisely. Let us work for heaven, not for this world, who is condemned to death. Let us work wisely. Let us follow our blessed Lord. In his passion, let's die to death. With his resurrection, be wise to Christian life through sanctifying grace. And with his ascension, we raise our mind and we ascend one day to heaven to receive the crown from his the good and faithful servants.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.